Hello, my dear children. Today we have a new lesson to learn, that is individual and society. Here's the diary entry of Mia. She is a 6th standard student. Let's read it. Saturday, 12 January. Mother woke me up as usual. I brushed my teeth, washed face, and sat with my brother to study. The milkman arrived by then. Mother prepared tea for us. The newspaper man came and I read the newspaper sitting near my father. By the time I got ready for school, grandmother had set food at the table. We all had breakfast together. Soon my friends Rema and Aisha came. I took my bag and rushed out to join them. While walking to school, I stepped back to give way to a vehicle. I tripped over a stone lying on the road. Aisha let out a loud cry. Someone came and took me to the nearby hospital. The doctor dressed up the wound. We took a rest for a while and then went to school. When we reached the class, our friends gathered around me and asked what happened. It was Rama who replied to everyone. The bell rang. In the first period, Shilpa teacher taught us English. How interesting her class is! Soon I forgot the pain in my wounded knee. So children, we have seen many different people Mia had to depend on for different needs in the morning. How many people do you interact with during the course of a day? Who are they? Yes, mother, father, brother or sister, grandmother, grandfather, aunt, uncle, etc. We all know that many persons are related to our life. Mother, father, siblings, neighbors, teachers, and friends. Here we can see a picture. Observe the picture and that form a web and identify the situations through which social relationships are created. We can see in the center a girl. She is related or interrelated with many people. Who are they? Yes, mother and father, siblings, neighbors, shopkeeper, doctor, teacher, etc. An individual begins to depend on others right from the time of birth. Family, neighbors, friends and teachers play important roles in the development of an individual. It is from the society that we internalize language, dress code, manners and culture. An individual establishes relationship with different people at each stage of his life. Society is a large group where such webs or relationships exist. Society forms the foundation for an individual's development and existence. Children, let's learn what is meant by society. According to Green, a society is a large group to which any individual belongs. So, we can see a video. After that video, we can understand what is meant by society.
Is a large group of people who share the same laws, rights, and resources. You can think of society as a type of community. But society is not always a small community like a neighborhood. In a neighborhood, people live close nearby. In a society, people can live far away from one another and still be a part of the same community. People in American society can also be very different. Hello. Bonjour. Ciao. Hola. Ni hao. They can speak different languages and belong to different cultural communities. But they are all part of the same society. The Lopez family lives in Texas. The Wilson family lives in Maine. They live very far away from one another. But they are all members of American society. They all share the same flag. Voting rights, and leadership. A society can also be a group of people who do the same type of work, like these doctors. Or people who believe in something together, like these animal protection volunteers. Members of these societies may not actually work or volunteer at the same place, but they are part of the same society because of what they have in common. So, what is a society? The people around you, near and far, are a society. What type of societies do you belong to? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.
Hope you understand what is meant by society. And this is all for today. And thank you.